Hypothyroidism is the most common endocrine complaint and has many causes, including defects in the thyroid itself, defects in the controlling mechanisms in the pituitary and hypothalamus, and defects in peripheral cell receptors, all leading to a common defect, the reduction in the actions of T3. It is nearly 10 times more common in women, and the incidence increases with age. Up to 15% of older women suffer from at least subclinical hypothyroidism. The degree of hypothyroidism determines the severity of the clinical symptoms. There is, though, significant individual variations, just as in hyperthyroidism. Looking at metabolism and nutrition, a hypothyroid patient will suffer from cold intolerance due to a reduction in metabolic rate and oxygen consumption. Their appetite is reduced and their food intake is below normal, yet they gain weight due to water and salt retention and accumulation of fat. Fat accumulation is due to a decrease in lipolysis, and there's also a decrease in protein turnover, leading to myopathy and general weakness. An increase in LDL cholesterol and an increase in homocysteine levels puts these patients at risk for coronary artery disease, and indeed all patients with hypercholesterolemia should be investigated for hypothyroidism. Serum creatinine levels are increased. In profound hypothyroidism, a hyponatremia develops due to water retention. Reduced exercise tolerance is also due to a slowing of heart rate and a reduction in myocardial contractility. Hypothyroid patients tend to have an elevated diastolic pressure, further worsening the coronary artery disease risk. On EKG evaluation, low voltages are often seen, and in part this is due to the development of pericardial and pleural effusions due to water retention. The skin is dry, pale and yellowish, with non-pitting edema, especially in the pre-tibial region, due to an accumulation of extracellular matrix proteins. There is coarse and brittle, and there's a reduction in sweating. Family and friends of hypothyroid patients may note sleepiness, a slowing of thought processes, and memory loss in these patients. Functional neurological imaging actually shows a reduction in cerebral blood flow and glucose metabolism. A reduction in the relaxation phase of deep tendon reflexes is a practical sign to elicit, and the patient should always be investigated for hypothyroidism should they present as such. Respiratory muscle weakness and an inappropriate response to hypoxemia and hypercapnia lead to hypoventilation in extreme cases. Hypothyroid patients suffer from constipation due to a slowdown in motor activity in the small bowel. In the case of autoimmune disease, there is an increased risk of pernicious anemia and gastric atrophy. In the case of primary hypothyroidism, there is a mild increase in serum prolactin levels, and this can lead to an increased risk of miscarriage in pregnant women and menstrual abnormalities in non-pregnant women, with the resultant decrease in fertility. Testosterone levels in men are reduced due to a reduction in sex hormone binding globulin. In the next video, I will discuss the list of causes of hypothyroidism and the concept of subclinical hypothyroidism.